Hey everybody, it's Tamika, and I'm coming to you today with two cards and a layout that I created for the Cutting Cafe, and I will post the information below. This week's challenge was to use Regina's pinwheel set, which is so cute. I just love it. Really, really love it. I went crazy with this. I love how, I just love, some of them are scalloped, some of them are square. They come in the format of PDF, SVG, WPC. And small and large and medium. And they also come with some circle sentiments and then these pre-made banners for you. They have, you know, there's different sayings on there just for you. There's a blank one. The simple things, one fun day, you know, it's your day, happy birthday, enjoy your day. All of these pre-cut banners. And I really enjoyed playing with this. So let me go ahead and share with you what I created. And sorry, for some reason, my webcam is not recording, so I'm doing this with my tripod. Okay, so the first card I created was using, it's a birthday card, and it was using the October Afternoon Sidewalks collection. Old paper, but I love, love, love it. And it was perfect for the pinwheels. It had pinwheels on it, actually. And here's what I did. So cute. It's a 5.5 by 5.5 inch card. And here's that gorgeous pinwheel. You can see that scintillating silver in the background. Look at that pinwheel. This birthday card is universal. It's very whimsical. So you could use it for just about anybody. And then I have layered it a few times. I layered it with 1, 2, 3 pattern papers. And I did some stitching, if you guys can see there, along the edges. I distressed all the pages with my Tim Holtz distressing tool. I layered a paper doily in the back, and then there's a gorgeous pinwheel. I used the stamp sticker from October Afternoon that came with the collection, and then if you can see, it says happy birthday. That's one of the 1-inch circles that comes with the set at the Cutting Cafe. And then I just held the pinwheel together with this pearl brad. Have a couple buttons down here, and here's that banner I just layered on pattern paper. If you can see, it's pretty dimensional. It says happy birthday. I love this card. And then the inside is just, I've matted some paper, put my sentiment there. So that's the first card. And then the second card, I told you guys I love these pinwheels. The second card I created is using the Flea Market paper collection by, who is this? Colorbach. Old paper as well, but I'm using stuff from my stash, so I love it. And here's what I created. So cute! It is using 3 of the small square pinwheels. This was using a large scallop pinwheel, and this is using 3 of the small squares. Small squares. And then I have the brads in the center. Layer of the paper collection, that's popped up on Pop Dots, so I can wrap this twine. In the back is burlap, a strip of burlap that I had left over. And then here is the sentiment. It says, give it a whirl. So with the pinwheels, give it a whirl. And then there's a key, since that paper has keys on it. I just attached a key, and then I tied it with some jute rope. Very, very cute. And then on the inside, just layer the pattern paper. And then since it has give it a whirl, to me that means try. And then I put down here, nothing beats a failure but a try. See, it's coming up here. But it says nothing beats a failure but a try. So give it a whirl. So that's 2 cards that I created. And then this next one is a layout. So I'm going to move these off the way so we can get everything in frame here. And I absolutely love how this turned out. So here it is. Ta-da! So cute. And of course there's a glare. Wouldn't be a video without a glare for me. Okay, I used the Bow Bunny Gabrielle paper collection in 12 by 12 paper stack. Again, old paper using my stash. Look at this layout, guys. It is so cute. So I'm going to show you, so I'll start up here. I used some recollections bling here. And then, let me see if I can span up a bit. Oh, okay. So all I did was I have 12 by 12 chipboard. I layered it with white piece of cardstock. And then I used the paper collection, cut that down to size in the peach and then the peach and white. And I used my die cut and cut out this turquoise color. I distressed all the edges with my Distress It All. And then I went over all of the edges with some white acrylic paint. And then I layered them with flatback pearls to frame the corner. And then I have some Say It In Pearls bling. And I used some flowers from my stash to color coordinate in peach and the light green colors. I used a resin, a porcelain flower, some Recollection small flowers here. Here is the pinwheel. I used, I don't even know how to pronounce this, conchbon, I don't know. It's a plastic piece like that. Tied some little bleached jute rope in the center there. Some frog feathers here. This is flowers from a swap, a handmade flower swap. I think it was Debbie that gave me that. And then I used a vintage button from my stash. This is a butterfly from the collection. I layered it with some lace that I had. This one I colored in Tuscan Sun from Tattered Angels. And then the satin trim, and then there's some lace peach trim underneath there. I cut my photo and layered, matted it, and then I did some acrylic painting on that. And then matted that piece onto another white piece of paper and popped that up on Pop Dot. So it's dimensional, and I, what do you call it? Distressed it with my, can't think of it. What is this called? Distress It All. So that's my layout, guys, for the Cutting Cafe. I really, really, really like how this turned out. Definitely going on my wall in my room. And then my birthday card. And then my encouragement card. So, you guys check out the Cutting Cafe. These pinwheels are fabulous. I love them. As you can see, I went crazy with them. So, I'll have some photos since this camera angle is kind of crazy for you guys. And leave a comment. Let me know what you think. Information will be down below in the description box. Bye.